whether it's in the Marriott, Oakland, or somewhere in San Francisco, or elsewhere in the Bay. I wonder if the children happened in the first place, am I right? Going to start off by hearing from an organization that does a lot of work in the Oakland community. Kat is here and ready to share some words about why Onyx and community members across Oakland oppose Urban Shield and police militarization. Make some noise for Kat, everyone.
Power to the people. Power to the people, fists in the air. Power to the people, fists in the air. My co-chair, GP, who's here with me, and a shout-out to the organizers. I am so juiced to see so many people out here saying no to Urban Shield, saying no to the militarization of our police force. Ferguson shone a bright light on something that Oakland residents know very well, that since the 80s, the military has been supplying our police with military weapons and technology that are utilized on the citizens when they are peacefully protesting. It was Alphabet City here, FBI, DEA, FATF, CIA. Remember all the black suits and the cars and the tanks during Oscar Grant and all the tanks and the technology during Occupy? This is nothing new. But this is our opportunity to get people that were not otherwise interested, that were horrified to see the streets of Ferguson look like Iraq. And I want to do a little calling out of our city council today, because I understand that some of them had representatives here saying no to Urban Shield, and oh, isn't this so terrible? But in case you didn't know, city council has to rubber stamp the expenditure for this event. They have to approve the expenditure for the firefighters and the police officers to be here for 4 days. So don't let them come out here and play like they don't know what's going on. They know exactly what's going on. And they want Urban Shield in Oakland because they want our police agencies to have this sweat technology. Because why? We stay in the streets. We stay in the streets, and we're going to stay in the streets, and we're going to run you right up out of Oakland. So power to the people.
Real quick, I want to follow up on what my co-chair was saying. For those of you who don't realize what's going on, literally this city is preparing for what it's going to do when martial law comes. When you take officers who are supposed to protect and serve normal citizens and you give them military training, then you are not training them to deal with citizens. They're only training to treat us like enemy combatants. They already have legislation that says that people like us who come out and defend our so-called civil rights are considered domestic terrorists because we don't agree with the laws of this country. And they turn around and use our space to teach these pigs how to further come out and violate us. But if we stand out here and do self-defense training, we're wrong. If we teach our people how to fight back, we're considered wrong. But they steady teach these pigs how to come out here and assault us, annihilate us, and murder us with more skill and more efficiency. Yet they say it's a cash-strapped county. So let's get Urban Shield out of here, people. Like Kat said, man, we're going to stay in the streets every time there's anything like this going on. So power to the people and all power to y'all for being here.
Put your fist up. Put your fist up one time. Put your fist up one time. If y'all ready, stop Urban Shield, make some noise, y'all. We are Bando 55. I want to keep the vibes going, keep the movement moving. Yeah.
Hearing from some of the members of our community that are speaking out against Urban Shield and trying to talk more about what it means to keep our community safe, we are going to hear from someone from the Malcolm X grassroots movement. Sunyaka has been throwing down in Oakland for years and years and years, trying to build a healthier and safer Oakland, and he's going to come up here and talk about why folks with the Malcolm X grassroots movement oppose Urban Shield.
Free the land, free the land, free the land. Sanyaka with Malcolm X grassroots movement. One thing to note, since 1968, when the first SWAT team was organized in Los Angeles in South Central, it was organized to combat primarily the Black Panther Party. Right, and so that's, we have to always keep in mind that this sort of activity is a direct result of the state trying to repress the political activity of the oppressed nationality communities in this country. Right? The only reason this sort of thing exists is to keep us in our place. The only reason we are morally obligated to stand against this whenever it comes down. And it's a great victory to announce too that they're not going to be having this at the Marriott next year because of the organizing of the people here for years against this sort of activity, right? So y'all need to give yourselves a round of applause for that victory. It's not the end. It's definitely not the end. We need to keep at it. Every 28 hours, a Black man, woman, or child is being killed extrajudicially in this country. Partly thanks to activities like this, partly because they're getting trained up in how to repress our communities. And that's open genocide. The way they're doing this against Black folks, they're doing it to Latino communities. They're directly tied to the surveillance activities of the state, directly tied to the expansion of the prison system. All of that is the interrelated system, same system, and I thank you so much for being out here to combat this, to call these pigs out, right, and just keep at it, educate yourselves about just the full extent of the national security state, the way it's coming down on the different communities out here, right, and build up a mass movement against it, right? That's all I got to say. Free the land.
All right, make some noise for some y'all guys about the Malcolm X grassroots movement. So another thing about the Malcolm X grassroots movement is that a little over a year ago, they put out a report about how a Black man is killed every 28 hours by police or security-type forces, and that is something important and relevant to today, especially here in Oakland, where the killing of young Black men is an epidemic, and it's something relevant across the U.S., because this is a major issue when we're talking about the impact of policing on communities of color. Now we are about to hear from Lara, who is with the Arab Resource and Organizing Center, also known as AROC, to talk about the ways that militarization and policing impact Arab and Muslim communities and immigrant communities and communities of color across the board. So Lara, come on up.
Hi, so my name is Lara and I'm with AROC. And AROC works to address the political, economic, and social impacts of anti-Arab and Muslim racism here in the Bay Area. And we organize, we advocate, and serve our community towards that end. And we see the impact of Urban Shield as the epitome of this, the policing, repression, and murder of brown and Black communities. We are here today to protest against Urban Shield. Urban Shield represents everything our communities have been fighting against for years, from the militarism, state repression, surveillance, policing, and state violence. We know that this doesn't begin or end with Urban Shield. However, we also know that we're here to put an end to one piece of this monster called global repression. Today, we've confirmed that our organizing has worked, and we've caused Urban Shield to move out of the Marriott for next year. We also know it's still planned to take place somewhere else in Alameda County. So we say no to Urban Shield anywhere, and we say no to militarism everywhere. We hold our city officials accountable for letting this happen in our city, just as we hold our city officials accountable for allowing the apartheid state of Israel to do business as usual in our neighborhoods, to train our police, to work with law enforcement corporations, neighborhoods, and city agencies. as Palestinians, as Arabs, we want the city of Oakland to know, we want the San Francisco Bay Area to know that we will not allow our colonizers to do business in our town. And we will not allow local police to terrorize our community. And we will hold every city official accountable for their role in making this happen. Recently, we blocked the steamship historic 4 days. The Bay Area made history. Not only is Jim linked to the racist, apartheid, and colonial state of Israel, the same state of Israel that massacres Palestinians day in and day out, but Zim also ships weapons from the state of Israel into our backyard to be used on our community. At the Port of Oakland, thousands of us in the Bay Area let the world know that Oakland, in Oakland, we make things happen on our own terms. We do not take orders from corporations, from corrupt governments, or police. Whether it's the corporations exhibiting their technology and equipment right across the street, or the corporations that are gentrifying our neighborhood, or they are really the root cause of violence. Whether Urban Shield really is the root cause of violence in our city and everywhere. They use this as an example of securing and making our neighborhood safe. The root cause of violence is the state. State violence is the root cause of violence. And we know that that violence is directed at the poor, at the brown, and the black. And we are here to let the world know that our communities will continue to resist state violence and repression. We are not scared of your weapons. We are not scared of your fear tactics. We are not scared of your expos or your exercises. As the people of Ferguson have shown, as the people of Palestine have shown, as we are showing today, we will continue to resist attempts to silence us, to cage us, to crush our movement. We are building a movement, and we will continue to do so until we are all free, from Ferguson to Oakland to Palestine. Thank you.
Some more noise for Lotto from A-Rock. Wiz is going to be coming up and talking about the reasons why Critical Resistance as an abolitionist organization supports resistance against Urban Shield. Give it up for Wiz, y'all.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Wiz Urban, and I'm a member of Critical Resistance. Critical Resistance is an abolitionist organization that fights to shrink and eventually eradicate the prison industrial complex, of which policing is a part. So today, Critical Resistance stands in solidarity to protest Urban Shield. The fundamental reason is because of what Urban Shield is actually here to accomplish, which is to increase the capacity for the expansion of war-making on black and brown communities. At Urban Shield, the technology that is distributed, the training, tactics, and strategies that are shared will be used to target communities of color in East and West Oakland. They will also be used on those who act in dissent and protest and organize for self-determination. Given that Oakland is policing resistant, Urban Shield's use of Alameda County as a testing ground becomes all the more chilling in its logic. In addition to its local impact, Urban Shield will continue the spread of police militarization nationally and internationally, the effects of which can be seen at present with the murder of Mike Brown and the turning of Ferguson and Missouri into a war zone when faced with community outrage and protest. The use of Israeli military training as part of Urban Shield connected to continued assault on Gaza. Urban Shield justifies itself in the same way that police militarization projects have always done, by utilizing exceptional circumstances as a reason to grow the military power. Supporting resistance against Urban Shield across the country, from Boston all the way here to Oakland, and Lotto is going to speak on their work and the impact of Urban Shield. Lotto, come on up. Tara.
Hey, y'all. My name is Tara, and I'm from the War Resisters League in New York City. So we're all here today to stop Urban Shield Oakland, but actually Urban Shield is happening in Boston, Dallas, Austin, and Fort Worth. It's a phenomenon that's taking over this whole country. Urban Shield also reaches around the world. It trains police departments from Brazil, Singapore, and South Korea, who are in here today.
a transfer of policing strategies is happening in the Marriott Convention Center right now. It's what allowed Israeli police to train St. Louis's former police department chief, Joseph Mukwa, in tactics of occupation and brutality that were used to oppress people in Ferguson. Inside those walls, a movement of money is happening too, between the weapons industry and global police departments. If you walk into those doors, you're going to see MRAP, TED, micro drones, tear gas canisters, military assault rifles. Those are wartime weapons that are being sold to police department reps in the U.S., such as Pittsburgh, Newark, and Minneapolis, and then those international police teams that are in there today. But if we took all these tactics and weapons away from the police, we would still be left with a mentality of policing and militarization, a mentality that has historically dehumanized and policed communities of Black, Brown, Muslim, Arab, poor, immigrants, gender non-conforming, and trans people all around this world. A mentality that makes t-shirts for sale inside that building that say, keep calm and return fire. Or a DNA machine that's made by Homeland Security that within 90 minutes checks if you have blood relatives in this country when you apply for a visa. Militarization and policing are always sold to the U.S. audience in the name of humanitarian intervention, right to protect, public safety, emergency responsiveness, rapid response, right? We know that with all that Department of Homeland Security funding, that none of that security is wartime profiteering. Urban Shield is one piece of a large movement of police militarization, a movement that brings together the war on drugs, the war on terror, the war on immigration, all down on communities in this country. We know that the police programs such as 1033 and 1122 that transfer weapons from the Pentagon to police departments, or fusion centers that survey our communities, or urban area security initiatives that fund 39 urban areas to have programs like Urban Shield is happening, right? And these are all part of the U.S. militarization movement that's grown around this world for decades. So at War Resisters League, we're working to end police militarization programs. We're looking to end the ways that communities across the globe are put under siege by state repression. So the Alameda County Sheriff's Office and the Pentagon, the weapons industry and the police departments, they're all coordinating, but so are we. We represent a lot of communities here today from around the globe, and we are powerful too. They're trying to build a movement of police militarization, but we have a people power movement. We can end police militarization. If you want to chat with me, no justice, no peace. No militarized police. No justice, no peace. No militarized police.
And resisting state violence and repression. So we're asking all of our allies here in the streets, all of our allies that can't be here today, to adopt these principles and take a stand against the policing and repression of our communities. Make some noise if you agree with these demands.
To make sure our demands are heard, we want to take this to the streets. So I want everyone to move towards off the sidewalk to the streets so we can take over and make sure our demands are heard and that we can show them our movement is going to the streets. Let's go.
If y'all feeling that organized people power, make some noise, y'all, for that organized people power with time. Because we believe in that community self-determination. We need to end police militarization. We're doing more than just hip hop, we're staying organized. We're saying no to Urban Shield. We all about that people power, community self-determination. Stop Urban Shield and police militarization. From Oakland to Ferguson to Palestine to Oakland, back to the Philippines and everywhere in between, we stand on the side of the people. Taking these streets back. We're Blend 255, providing our music for the movement.
came out today to, of course, show support, solidarity, and shutting down this insidious program, which was instituted through the Patriot Act and, of course, through Homeland Security. Homeland Security, of course, now is the 8th annual, you know, event that they're having here in training police, regular police, and military training, and, of course, in, you know, the arms as far as the tanks and, of course, the weaponry that they use over there in Afghanistan in foreign wars. It doesn't make any sense why they're going to institute this particular program for the community that they're supposed to serve, protect and serve, when in reality they've become the biggest bullies and the biggest gangs in the world. And I'd just like to say that all the people here, all the groups that are representing the civil rights movement here today, it's a beautiful thing to see the solidarity. And as you can see, all races are represented, all creeds, all colors, two-spirited, non-spirited. All these people are really here in solidarity to bring voice to this and to call attention to the fact that we need this program shut down, and particularly so that we can fund more vital programs that are beneficial for the general welfare of the community.
Right on, brother. Peace.
No worries. You want them to see the sign?
Right?
Money.
We are nothing but a product. that's been stolen. Our organs are being stolen. My son's bone marrow was taken out of his body. James Cook's brain was gone. James Cook's throat was gone. So we've been finding out that these corners been taking part. Why every time that we lose a loved one, the police take the body? You murder, you get a crime, and you take the body? We gotta stop that damn law. Why have all of us been put on the market? I'm on the market now. You on the market. We all got a day. So what we gonna do? We gonna sit here and feel sorry for our goddamn self, and we gonna organize and get it voted. What we gonna do? And I want you to look right now. I want you to look at everybody next to you. You are your brother's keeper. You are your brother's keeper. Anybody got kids out here? Anybody got a grandmother out here? Anybody got a nephew or niece? You look at them and you hold on to him and let him know that you're gonna fight and you're gonna care for him. You educate him. Because we learn from our mother first. When the day we come out of our mother's womb, we learn mama, dad, dad. So we got to give to our community. We can't expect for them to give us shit. We not expect for them to give us food. We not expect for them to give them housing. She done chicken a bit, the chicken coming next door. She done got enough car shit coming in the car to get you some. That's what the mentality when we have to have. Stop fighting each other. Only time they come in our community is when one of us dead. Then they pretend that they're looking for, oh, we ain't found the criminal. Why you ain't found the criminal? Because you know why? You know why they ain't found the criminal? They got plea bargains. You give us three, you walk. The guns, how the guns get in the ghetto? Come on, y'all, how many of y'all got a ship? A plane? Come on now, ship, we can't even go to Africa for free. Come on now. You know what I'm saying? So why do we got all these guns in the poor community? They don't throw a damn flag up. Why are kids is bringing guns to school? Now look at all these kids have been with guns. Look at the one that killed Sandy school. Look at
San Diego.
But anyway, every time we see on the news that someone kills something or have guns, don't you know the police don't kill them? Police kill the ones with no guns.
That's right.
Everybody you know have had a day in court. They can play crazy or whatever. But why do they get a day in court and we can't get a day in court? They silence the ones that kill. So we don't hear but one story. So I want to tell you I love you. I'm here. I've been organizing for 4 years because I'll tell y'all because I was like y'all. I was blind too. I had a big old 3-bedroom house, big nice car. Every year I want to buy me a car. So I know how you think. But check this out. Death knocked at my door. And guess what? It was my baby boy. And his name was James Rivera, 16 years old. My son was full of life. My son was full of love. When they took my son, they took a piece of me. And long his blood is on these streets, I'm going to continue to march. And I don't give a damn if we have to march, whatever. Because I ain't going nowhere. And God bless.
My name is Cindy Mitchell. I'm here from Vallejo. I'm here for my brother, Mario Romero, who was murdered by Vallejo police. He was shot over 40 times as he sat in front of his house. Okay? Police covered it up. The police are not drug tested, okay? The police in your community, they have a vested interest in keeping crime in your community. They're getting armed with guns. And they are not volunteering to be randomly drug tested or psychologically evaluated, okay? This is terrorism on American soil. It's time for us all to stand up, okay? We come out here, we come to Oakland, we come to all the protests and the rallies in Oakland. It don't take too long to get to Vallejo. Stand with us too, okay? Because we're standing with you guys. We expect you guys to stand with us, okay? We're going to Stockton. We're going everywhere. We're organizing, okay? It takes all of us to stand together to combat this police brutality, okay? We need to get laws created so that they can be drug tested. They should not be allowed to police themselves. okay? My brother was murdered. He was shot through the palms of his hands and underneath his arms. The officer jumped on the hood of his car and continued to unload bullets. My brother was unarmed. They planted a gun in front of witnesses inside of the crime scene, okay? And they were allowed to say that he was a parolee who was afraid of going back to prison, although he had never been on parole and had never been to prison, okay? Take the time to pay attention to the stories, because they will make it seem like they're doing your community a favor when they're murdering us. This is terrorism. Where is our food shipment? Where's our drop ship? Okay? They're terrorizing us, and people don't seem to pay attention until it affects them. Okay? Our family now, your family later. Okay? We need to stand up. Okay? We need to stand up and unite and come together. Thank you, guys. No justice, no peace.
To come and go how they need to
disorder is an illness. City of Oakland, shame on you. You should have gotten that man some help, and my baby would be alive today. We know when you come back from war that you cannot go on the job and be productive working 10 hours and 15 hours on our tax dollars. We want someone that's going to go to work and do their job. Protect and serve this community. Bridge this community. Take your military tactics and get out of here. Don't bring it back to Oakland. Urban Shield my foot. That's not a shield. You're hiding behind your weapons of mass destruction. You see my face? You hear my voice? My son said he didn't do anything, but I tell you, Geraldine Brooks Buford is going to do everything she can to make sure that this does not go on. All power to the people. One love. Peace.
They will be here next year in 2015, so we must say thank you to the organizers because we know they will not be here in 2015. Community as Uncle Bobby. I stand here as an male and an uncle, but we must love these teary-eyed mothers, so those last four mothers that you heard speak, as well as you hear myself speak, have intimately been affected by the militarization of the police. And so what they're doing here in Oakland, we're appalled at. So we want to say to all of you who are standing here today, thank you for coming out here. Thank you for supporting this event. Thank you for speaking to this issue. We were in Ferguson 2 days after Michael Brown was killed. We were in the street with the youth in the community that was out there. We witnessed the militarization in Ferguson. Oakland is being prepared just like Ferguson police were prepared for what happened. But I'm going to tell you, united, we stand. Divided, we will fall. So let us, no matter what, stay united, because them youth, that community stood and faced off with that militarization, and they know today that as long as they stand, a change will come. But what's more important for you to know, they recognize Oakland. They asked me about Oakland, and they're on their way here because they've heard how Oakland has stood up. There's no city like Oakland. Give yourselves a round of applause. The militarization of the police across this country is real. Last year, we didn't have this many people, but this year is even larger. But no matter what, wherever they're militarizing at, we still got to come out and support the cities that they're trying to set up the militarization type of game, where they'll be like here at the Marriott Hotel, selling arms, showing off their weaponry, new designs to kill people in the street. Our babies are dying in the street.
The police are gang.
The police are gang. We cannot get that twisted. The weaponry that is being put in their hands, they're killing at will. There's no more of an intimate relationship with us in the community. So we must, as a community, stand together, speak to this issue, and do not fear the fact that they have this weaponry. Because I'm telling you, a people united cannot be defeated.
That's right.
What did I say? A people united
cannot be defeated.
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 From Ferguson to Oakland.
From Ferguson to Oakland.
From Ferguson to Oakland.
From Ferguson to Oakland.
Again, from us, we want to thank you. I mean, sincerely, from our hearts, for you being here, because this is what families that have suffered this crime and militarization need, the support of the community. Because if you don't stand up, it can't come to your door. So we love you, we thank you, and we appreciate all of you.
Hey, immigrant, Arab and Muslim, and disabled communities of color. Israeli security forces have participated directly in Urban Shield in years past, and this year they still have vendors that are supplying police with weapons for their war games. Companies like Safari Land that has used tear gas against the Palestinian people. That's right. What are we in a jungle? Israel's connection to Urban Shield is not strange or exceptional, but rather a part of its broader role in worldwide repression, in which Israel takes the technology, military tactics and expertise, and racist brutality that it's developed over half a century of settler colonialism and ethnic cleansing, and it exports that right back to our communities here. And all of this happens with U.S. funding. We give Israel $3 billion a year in aid. It's nearly 20% of the Israeli military budget. The former police chief of St. Louis County Police Department, which has been ruthlessly working to suppress the ongoing rebellion against white supremacy in Ferguson, participated in a so-called counterterrorism training in Israel, which we can understand as training in the tactics involved in a racist military occupation. The Oakland Police Department has themselves trained alongside Israeli border police in previous Urban Shield exercises. None of this is an accident, but a predictable consequence of the fact that Israel and the United States have a shared investment in maintaining and profiting off the systems of white supremacy, imperialism, and global capitalism. Urban Shield is just one of the spaces where this collaboration happens concretely on the ground, and it's therefore a space where we can resist it. Because just as global elites and militaries are collaborating with one another to better oppress us, so too are we building across borders, communities, and movements to advance a joint struggle toward collective liberation. Joint struggle is about recognizing the differences and distinctiveness of the places our communities are struggling, the circumstances that confront us, and the histories we've inherited, while working to build shared political ground, alliances across our movements, and a common vision of a more just and dignified future. It means finding and organizing around shared sites of struggle like Urban Shield, where we can work strategically in ways that advance our collective aspirations. I'm
I'm going to end with a quote from the black lesbian feminist poet Audre Lorde, which was written more than three decades ago, that articulates this politics of joint struggle so beautifully. We have chosen one another at the edge of each other's battle. The war is the same. If we lose, someday women's blood will congeal upon a dead planet. If we win, there is no telling. We seek beyond history for a new and more possible meeting. Thank you.
All right, shout out to IJAM, the International Jewish Anti-Zionist Network, a strong, strong ally of many of the organizations that have gotten on here and spoken on the mic today. We are now going to
see the connection between our police and military. We face military recruiters in the halls of our schools, constantly using advertisements and video games to brainwash our students. These same military forces primarily target low-income students and students of color. The same military forces that are encouraging our youth to become an occupying force. We also experience profiling from law enforcement outside of our schools, especially if we are people of color. The line between police and military is starting to blur. We refuse to stay silent as Arab Americans and will not stand back as our fellow youth of color face police brutality and the increasing militarization of their communities. Constantly when we turn on the news and see the brutality of civilians they face in other countries, the trauma they endure. However, little do we actually consider the fact that those the same tactics and oppressive techniques already being used on us here in the U.S. Our government is funding local police departments to learn and get trained by people who occupy, torture, harass, and violate civilians globally. Urban Shield is an event that brings together state, local, and global forces to teach each other tactics and provide technologies primarily for crowd control purposes. At the same time, Urban Shield also provides counter-terror trainings that are designed specifically to target members of the Arab and Muslim community. Department of Justice, Homeland Security, Department of Defense, CIA, FBI, Sheriff's Department, and your local police department are all learning tactics used by the Israeli military. Technologies that were used to indiscriminately kill and monitor Palestinian populations are being repackaged and sold to our state forces as field-tested weapons. We don't need our so-called protectors to become militarized. We need a new system that is community-based and free of racism. We need to feel safe going out instead of living in fear that a police officer may harass, abuse, and even kill us and then get away with it. We need to stop being profiled, criminalized, harassed, and dehumanized by law enforcement just because we are youth of color. Michael Brown, Oscar Lopez, Alex Nieto, Andy Lopez, Trayvon Martin, and youth in Palestine have all been victims of this system, and it's time we put an end to this brutality. Our youth must live free knowing what it means to be racially profiled by police, especially when those police are packing military-grade weapons. Thank you.
All right, Oakland, let me hear you! If you haven't already gotten the news, thanks to years of organizing in the San Francisco Bay Area, thanks to years of community grassroots organizing right here in Oakland against police brutality, against militarism, thanks to the Facing Urban Shield Network, which AROC is proudly a part of, we have shut down Urban Shield at the Marriott next year. This is a huge victory, and we don't take it lightly. But we also want city officials, especially Jean Kwan, to know it is no thanks to her. It is thanks to our efforts on the ground, organizing our communities day in and day out to challenge police repression, to challenge the state, to challenge Jean Kwan and her sanctioning of Urban Shield for the last few years. It is because of us that we stopped Urban Shield at the Marriott next year. And it is because of us that we're going to stop Urban Shield anywhere. Urban Shield is planned for again in Alameda County next year, and we're going to continue to organize against it. We're going to continue to organize against any form of militarism, because militarism doesn't start or end with Urban Shield, and militarism doesn't start or end with the police. We're going to challenge it everywhere and anywhere, as Arabs, as Muslims, as black and brown communities, as poor, as LGBTQ you as disabled, we're going to work hand in hand to stand against global repression, because we've done it in Oakland, we've made history in Oakland, and we're going to continue to make history. Our demands for the Urban Shield Network are still relevant. We encourage you to get on our website until racism stops. We're not going to stop until police militarism stops, and we've shown that we can do that. And we're going to organize again at the Port of Oakland to block that dim ship that further militarizes our community. We encourage you to get on our website to learn more, to talk to our organizers. Stay tuned, continue to mobilize, and be proud of the change we've already made. Long live Palestine, long live international solidarity, and police brutality.
Thank you.